Hello, everybody. Can I have your attention? Can I have everybody's attention, please? Hi, I'm Jim Cox. I'm the chair of the Cathedral City Public Arts Commission, and I'd like to welcome everybody. This is quite a crowd, and we're very excited that you all came to join us today for this very special opening. This is Pam Price, who I'd like to introduce. She's also in the Arts Commission, and she's basically responsible for pulling this exhibition together. And Marilyn Cooper, who's on the Arts Commission as well. Where are you, Marilyn? Right over here. She's our curator for these exhibitions. And we regularly have exhibitions here in the lobby of City Hall. As you see, we don't have a lot of wall space, but we still have some very great exhibitions there. And so we're very excited about this one today with the photography of Donald Cravens. I'd also briefly introduce the other arts commissioners who are here. Alan Carvalho is right here, doing our video as well. And Greg Murphy, okay, and Steve Vericker is here, right there. Hi, Steve. And basically, I'm just going to introduce a couple of people who are going to say a few words, and I'd like to start with Jarvis Crawford, sorry. Jarvis is the chair of the Martin Luther King Commemoration Committee, and he's also the chair of the Palm Springs Black History Month Committee.
Thank you both for inviting me out today. I'm glad to see you all come out for such a historic day. There's not many people that we can talk about in American history that has a day that we can recognize the works that they have done over the years. Being a part of the Martin Luther King Commemoration Committee over the last 10 years, I've been able to take in and be a sponge to a lot of my elders to tell me about the Civil Rights Movement. No, I'm not old enough to have experienced it. But I am old enough to be able to take advantage and learn the history that was set forth from the Civil Rights Movement. And just to share with you all a few words, I want to first say thank you to the Cathedral City Arts Commission and the City of Cathedral City for this event. Not too many places in our valley will hold events like this to honor Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. I have with me a copy. It's an obituary from Martin Luther King's funeral services. And I was looking over it today. I was at an event in Desert Hot Springs, and we had a gentleman there, Reverend Talib McNeeshaw. He had did a rendition of the MLK I Have a Dream speech, and I was touched by it. And I just looked through the obituary while I was listening to the words being read from Dr. Martin Luther King and looked back at one thing that he had put in that was written by him. And it says here, "I tried to love and serve humanity." Dr. King said, "If any of you are around when I have to meet my day, I don't want a long funeral. And if you get somebody to deliver the eulogy, tell him not to talk too long." So I'm not going to talk too long. "Tell them not to mention that I have a Nobel Peace Prize. That isn't important. Tell them not to mention that I have 300 or 400 other awards. That's not important. Tell them not to mention where I went to school. I'd like somebody to mention that day that Martin Luther King Jr. tried to give his life serving others. I'd like for somebody to say that day that Martin Luther King Jr. tried to love somebody. I want you to say that day that I tried to be right on the war question. I want you to be able to say that day that I did try to feed the hungry. And I want you to be able to say that day that I tried in my life to clothe those who were naked. I want you to say on that day that I did try in my life to visit those who were in prison. I want you to say that I tried to love and serve humanity." And that was written Sunday, February 4th, 1968. Now, I want you all to remember, today is not a day for a barbecue. It's not a day to go out and get a sale, to take advantage of sales that are going on, because every holiday there's a holiday sale going on. I don't want you to use this day as a day that, you know what, I don't have to be at work, so I'm going to sit down and rest. Let's remember that days like these are days of service. And I thank this city for showing that today is a day of service and not just another day off. And let us all know that Martin Luther King, yes, he fought for civil rights for African Americans, but it was for civil rights for all Americans to understand the importance of each and every American that is here. Thank you, guys.
Thank you, Jarvis. Thank you for those words. And now a couple of words briefly about the artist for our exhibition, and that's Donald Cravens. This man was a very famous and very renowned photojournalist for Life magazine for years and years, and was present and a part of a lot of the greatest history of the 20th century. And his images actually helped to affect some of the changes in the 20th century because they were so iconic and so impactful. And we're very thrilled to have these photos today from Martin Luther King and the actual birth of the Civil Rights Movement, because the birth of the Civil Rights Movement was in Montgomery, Alabama in the year 1955. It started on December the 1st with Rosa Parks being tired that day and not wanting to give up her seat for a white man. And she didn't. She was arrested soon after they started the Montgomery bus boycott, and Donald Cravens was there through all of this and created these fabulous, iconic images. And we're very thrilled and excited to have his wife, Peggy Cravens, here, and I'd like to introduce her to you right now.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. Hi up there, this is for you. Indeed, he would be so, so thrilled to know that a lot of these things that he lived through, and on some occasions he almost did not, but you're so lovely to come and be with me today. These photos, a lot of them are very iconic and will always be, I'm sure. But there's a lady here today that I would like to invite to come up and speak next to me. She's with the Desert Sun. Her name is Denise Goolsby. And I put her in touch with the gentleman that Don was a photojournalist, but when they covered he covered almost the entire civil rights movement. But he also covered it with a journalist, and the journalist's name was Dick Stolle. Dick Stolle, of course, became the executive editor for the entire Life magazine, Time and Life. And bless his heart, he's still with us today. I believe he has to be either 88 or 89 years old, but sprightly and wonderful. And I gave his name to Denise, and I said, Denise, call him. He will tell you the fabulous, not so fabulous, really, but the story about the boots in the cell. Denise, would you like to come up and talk about your conversation with Mr. Stolle? Denise Goolsby.
Okay, Peggy's put me on the spot. This is, I called Peggy last week to do a preview story about this great exhibit, and the last thing she said before she got off the phone, she said, you've got to give Dick Stolle a call and ask him about the boots in the empty cell photograph. Well, she was kind enough to give me his cell phone number. He had just flown into New York that night, and we chatted for 45 minutes, and it was probably one of the most amazing talks I've ever had with anybody. And he talked about Don, and he talked about the night that they, of this horrible tragedy that happened. I don't remember the man's name, but an African-American man was picked up on a Friday night, and I think he was accused of attempting to rape or bothering a white woman who was in a car. Okay. And the husband had gone because the car had broken down. The husband came back. The wife told him what had happened, and so they go to the sheriff's. The sheriff's throw him in jail. Later that night, a mob comes in, gets into the jail, drags him down the stairs, takes him out to this a bridge over the Pearl River, and from what Dick said, they were going to castrate him, but I guess a car drove by. They shot him, and they threw him off the bridge into the water. They didn't find his body for a couple of days. Don was working as a bureau Dick Stolle was working as a bureau chief in Atlanta. He called Don up. They got into Don's private plane. They flew out there. This was a little place in Mississippi. And they were a little nervous because you just never know what's going to go on in that time. It was 1954 in the South. And Dick thought that we should go to the police and let them know their presence is there. Life magazine is in town in case something happened to them, God forbid. So they go to the sheriff, and they said, Dick says, hey, can we go see the jail? And the deputy takes him to the jail, takes him, unlocks the jail, walks up the stairs, and I guess on the stairs as they were walking up, there was still blood there from where he was dragged down and he banged his head down. They got up the stairs and looked in the jail cell, and I guess Dick and Don realized right away what a moving, powerful photo it would be. They saw a pair of boots, empty boots, in an empty cell. And so while Dick kept the deputy occupied, Don went in there and he took photos. And the one you see on that wall is an iconic photo. And it's very moving, and for me to just hear the story behind it. And the next day, they went out to try and find the farmer. And they went to the farmer's home, the man that was in charge of the mob, and they climbed the fence and went over there, and they're faced with three shotguns and told them, basically, get the hell off my property. So they went through a lot of dangerous situations just to get these photos. That's just one. So
thanks, Peggy. Thank you so much. Yeah. Well, I know there are so many more stories that I could tell you about, not only civil rights stories, when Don covered Nuremberg trials, and I mean, he's been all over the place, but the nicest human being you ever knew. Very quiet, very charming, very handsome. And of course, during the civil rights movement, it was bad enough that you were labeled a journalist, but if you were a photojournalist, oh my God, they really didn't want to know you at all, because a lot of those photographs were used in the trials that would come forward later. And so Don was in danger. Don and Dick were in danger many, many times when working these events in the South. But I thank you very much for coming. And the exhibit is small, I must admit. Don did exhibit twice at the Walter Marks Art Center on the campus of COD. It was a much larger exhibit, but it encompassed a lot of his work. And I will say to this wonderful young man that spoke earlier, you've done a fabulous job. Don knew Dr. King, Coretta, and the kids very intimately, loved Dr. King. And of course, that fateful day when he was shot, it was, I mean, everybody just, time just stops. But I will say this, the fact that the movie Selma has been released at this particular time, with what's going on in the United States and elsewhere with regard to segregation of any kind, I think that it's very timely that these photographs are revived again. And I know Dr. King would be so, Don would be so proud that Dr. King is now represented for a lifetime in this movie and expressing all the things that Dr. King was about. And hopefully some good will come of this and we'll all come to our senses and realize that we must do what Dr. King said, and if we're going to protest, we should protest in a civil way. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Peggy. I just wanted to add a couple of things. First of all, this exhibition will be on display until March 31st, so it's going to be up for a while. So please tell friends, neighbors to come by and check it out. It's open whenever City Hall is open, and that's often during the week, obviously business days. And I also wanted to point out that our chief of police is here.
There he is.
Right here. George Crum. And George told us earlier that he grew up a half an hour from Montgomery, Alabama. So that's kind of his home territory there. Our mayor, Stan Henry, is here. And we also have three other commissioners. We have Greg Pettis, Shelley Kaplan, and Mark Carnevale are also here. Thanks for your presence. I'm sorry, I forgot your name, gentlemen. That's right, sorry, John. And John Aguilar, other commissioner is here. And also Eduardo Garcia, state assemblyman, is here as well. Thanks for coming. We have a lot of other great people here today. We have great artists from the Valley. We have people from the Arts Museum. And also wonderful cuisine, specially made for us from Bonnie at Cello's. Thank you, Bonnie. And Dr. Kahneman from College of the Desert. One last note, I don't know if anybody's mentioned it so far, but 2015 makes the 50th anniversary of the birth of the Civil Rights Movement. That was 1955, so it's now been 50 years. Anything else, anybody else like to be introduced? No? Okay, there is an exhibition, Three Contemporary Artists of the Diaspora, Downs, Lexington Garrick, and Bernard Stanley Hoyes at the Palm Springs Arts Museum. And this is a presentation of from the Black History Committee. And this is, the opening is February the 5th, 6 to 8 p.m. at the Palm Springs Art Museum. Great. And the presenter is Helene Galen, who I think you're all aware of, great arts patron of the Coachella Valley. I think that's it for spoken words. If you haven't had a chance yet to get inside and see the exhibition, please do. And once again, thank you all for coming. Have a good afternoon.